I don't see the reason why a minister makes a statement and the CEO who works under him is not aware of it, has not been briefed, has not been sat down and made to understand that government has changed its policy. What we sold to Ghanaians is this. They have bought it. Now we want to go this. That is a very serious problem. It can be converted to a tampon. Father, this is a legacy asset, a strategic asset to Ghana. So I believe that turning it to a tank farm is not the most appropriate.
The minority spokesperson on mines and energy, Adam Mutawakilu, insisted Tor should not be ignored because of a decision to build a new refinery.
It broke down about a year ago, and according to the CEO, last weekend they were supposed to restart. So it is not that it has not made any profit. If you are bringing in a new refinery, it must be complete. You don't bring in the refinery and then you go and cannibalize another company and convert it to a tank farm. They must come alongside with this all infrastructure so that we truly, this is an addition.
Meanwhile, the Tema District Council of Labour has waded into the tank farm controversy between Tor and the Energy Ministry. Chairman of the council, Emmanuel Adokumi, says government must make its position clear on the matter that has left officials of the refinery and the ministry on a collision course.